don't know, so let's just start with the left and go right. So, Yamura Kazuo.
Haru cut. I'm gonna roll me a knowledge roll.
All right.
I guess you wouldn't be able to recall immediately since it's been a while, but Haru will kind of laugh. He'll be like, I can't say I'm surprised you don't remember. He's quite the reclusive man. I suppose you've only seen him the once. When you first came to the academy.
Oh, the headmaster.
Yes, he is the headmaster of the of Mirai Academy. He was in the pamphlet as well. I heard his speeches get quite long. But yes, he is the principal of Mirai Academy.
Okay. Anything else I should know?
Well, he's come from a line of a well-established family who's well into the education sector. I believe he's part of GenCorp, which is an administration board for education, close ties to the government. You can thank Dainey for that one.
Daisuke is the middle child, Jess.
I know.
Why'd you call him Dainey?
Because he said it as if you were saying thank you.
Ah, okay. So I see even schooling, I can't get away from you guys, okay? So how about Kuroki?
Ah, Professor Kuroki. Well, you haven't taken any of the extracurricular classes, have you? He's the head of mythological studies. Maybe one of your friends has taken the, I believe colloquially it's known as the magic class. He directs that one. He's also known for the Kuroki principle as well, which I suppose you haven't come across if you haven't been schooled in these things.
No, the only one that I know that's doing anything with magic is the kid who dyed his hair in the dorm.
Oh, right. Well, even though I've barely met him, that's quite the memorable appearance. I would say it's between her and him, not the girl, him and Kazuhaya for the standouts. But
pretty much, yeah. Yes.
Professor Kuroki tends to be quite eclectic. He seems to weave myth and reality together, and sometimes you can't quite tell the two apart. If it's going to be somebody on your side, it will definitely be Kuroki. You might want to stay sweet to him.
Right, I'll keep that in mind. All right, Tomasa?
Can you roll me a knowledge roll? Alright.
The exact same one.
Alright, you've actually seen this guy around.
Okay.
And you would know that he is part of the student council.
Ah, right, okay. That's not exactly something Ryu puts too much attention to. He's the student council president, right?
Yes, that took you longer than it should have. Not interested in the affairs of the academy, I suppose.
Not normally, no.
Tomasa tends to be a bit, he's very guided. He sticks to the rules, but he always manages to bend them if it means that student welfare is put as the priority. He doesn't feel like throwing people to the wolves. He's very invested in rehabilitation and correctional matters.
Right. Okay. Right. Metagame, would the Nakamatsu be someone I've heard about before?
Roll me another knowledge roll. All right, so you would know that Nakamatsu is the surname of a very famous inventor who passed away a decade ago. And the famous inventor who passed away a decade ago was Yasuhiro Nakamatsu, and he was a famous inventor who had the world record for the amount of patents he held. Over 4,000.
Patents, okay.
Patent. Yeah, those things. And Nakamatsu Hajime is his son, and he was named after Yoshiro's grandfather, who was Hajime Nakamatsu, who was a banker.
Mm-hmm.
So this guy is fairly well known in the business world. Surpassing even his father.
Anything major I should remember about Nakamatsu-san?
Well, out of everybody on the board, I would please advise not to say anything too rash. He is the head of the families that our brother are trying to get us acclimatized to.
Right, okay, I'll do that.
I forgot what the name was. The
engineers?
Gijichi, the Gijichi-sa. Yes, and the technicians.
Yeah, technicians.
Gijichu-sa is the official name. Was it Hogo-sa? No, it's not Hogo. Hogo is the guardians. Kanishi is the right.
Not.
Way beyond me. All right.
I too like Japanese names.
But yeah, TLDR, he's the head of the technician bloodline.
Okay. And of course, Atsuko.
And Atsuko Hitomo is the mate of the mayor of Asate's secretary.
Ah, okay.
And it is into safeguarding and welfare of Asate City.
Right. That's probably going to be the one that's going to be the hardest against me.
Yes.
All right. Anything I need to know about Minamoto-san?
And he'll be like, as you're approaching the school, there's a lot I could tell you, but we don't really have the time. The important thing to know is that when it comes to keeping Japan Japanese, well, he's the one at the top.
Right. And I suppose I might as well ask it. What information have you got for me about Genda?
He'll just kind of put a finger to his lips and he'll be like, I wouldn't spill out any secrets of a treasured friend. And he'll be like, come along now.
Right. Somehow I figured you were going to say that. Well, I am kind of curious how you two became friends.
In business, connections and networking is everything.
Right.
And I suppose if you want, you have a bit of like downtime in the waiting room if you want to like do anything before you go in.
No, he's probably just going to coordinate information with his brother.
All right. Ray, are you still? Oh,
yeah, I'm
good.
Here.
Like maybe it'll probably be an event or something.
Oh, okay. You want me to go find the Phoenix Wright court case music?
Yeah, that would be great.
All right, okay. Shit, what's that called? I know.
Let me look at my.
I used to know all the names. I thought I had that in Roll.
I've got the OST on my computer.
I used to have that on Roll 20, to be honest. And I used to. Let me go.
Video game music. Phoenix Wright.
It's not cornered, I know.
It depends on what heart it, on what game it is.
Spirit
suspense?
Justice.
Objection? Let me just try core.
Kardashians!
Kardashians! Oh, yeah, there's always things. Oh, it might be this one. That's the beginning of it.
There's a really good one from the latest game. I'm trying to remember what it's called.
Okay.
The basics of the case.
Okay.
Yeah, that one.
There you go. All right, cool. Oh, yeah. That's pretty good.
You can add.
I'm not logged in on any of these.
Yeah. I'll add that later.
All right, yeah, you'll do. Cool.
Somebody else is playing as well.
I don't think so.
Yeah, it is. Yeah.
No.
I
really heard not. So. That's on your end, dude. Unless there's just a background track, dude. I don't know.
It is something else.
Is there just two things being fucking played in there?
No, I think it's just that one.
Let's see. Yeah, that's what I mean.
Alright.
Maybe the other one's a remix.
It did say hashtag mix. Alright, is this good?
Yeah, that would be.
Sorry, just and I looked for a specific music track and it derailed things a bit.
I am not even surprised.
It was pretty fun though, I enjoyed the journey.
Alright, so I guess if you don't want to like prepare anything, you can just go straight in, right?
Yeah, it's like I said, Ryu is probably going to go over some of the basic information with his brother about what to do and like that. But nothing major.
Alright, so you'll be given, like, the notice by one of these, because you'll be in the office area. You'll be given the notice to go into the meeting room, and you'll go down a couple stairs.
Okay.
And there'll be, like, a fairly smallest room. It's fairly oldest feeling. Give me a moment.
In the corners?
You kind of feel like everything's been like stripped down to basics in here. It's not as over the top as it seems on the normal school rooms and stuff.
Okay.
All right, and there'll be two open sheets when you walk in.
Well, unless they tell him to sit, Ryu is just going to stand beside one of them.
All right. So, who would be the main talker?
Are there personas out?
No. Let me move these names about appropriately. Okay, so Tomasa would actually be closest to you. And then this can be you, and this can be your brother.
Okay.
There we go. And I guess the oldest looking man in, not as old as Minamoto, but he's fairly oldest. He'll be like, please sit down there, Takinaki.
Ryu will take the seat.
Haru will sit at the same time. And I guess he will be like, I suppose you'll have things to do and preparations to be made. So I suppose I'll be quite blunt about this. And he'll just kind of cough. He'll be like, so, do you know the reason why you're here?
Yes, I do.
Right. Well, I suppose before we get down to the matters, if there's anything that you'd like to say before a more direct approach, then we are all ears.
Let's see. Ryu's going to throw his understanding to see if he understands what they want him to do.
All right.
Of course, Ryu's got low understanding.
Oof. All right, you generally feel like anything that you feel is relevant, even if you don't feel like it's particularly relating to this cause, as long as you talk about yourself, like they just want to hear it so they have more to work off of.
You mean basically...
You get the feeling that being quiet would be really bad right here.
Okay, since I'm not entirely sure you will... talk about what it is the knowledge rule tells him he should talk about.
Basically, like, just talk. You know? Like, what else can they do? These guys probably already know everything anyway.
Right, I suppose, like I said, I'm not really sure that's why the whole understanding is this response. So I would say he'll admit that how badly he fucked up and he's going to clean it up. That's what his plans are to do, and that he's starting to learn about his family or whatnot.
I think it's also like a time to throw, if you're going to throw anybody under a bus.
No. I think it's mostly just, like, present a good enough case because we don't want to get rid of potential good students, but we also have to appeal to people. I think that's basically it. It's the very much like, yes, I've made a mistake and I'm reforming. It's like the sports athlete talk after they get caught saying something racist or have a drug scandal. They just have to talk for a while saying they're going to be good and people will blow it off.
Right. Do you actually want me to actually state it out, or can I just say that that's what he does?
Well, yeah, you can go into more, because they'll ask you very specific questions later. It's basically like, do you have anything to say for yourself before we begin?
Yeah. So this is just the initial thing.
So just the initial thing. So Ryu will basically admit that he screwed up badly. He's planning on working on cleaning up the situation. And his connection with Vitala might be dispersing soon.
Speaking of which, you don't feel anything from Vitala as soon as you stepped into the room.
Well, Vitala's been pretty quiet since the discussion, so...
Yeah, but you don't sense anything. It's completely gone. Like, poof.
Right, okay.
Alright. And, give me a moment. And you would notice that, like while the principal was talking, he seems in very bad health, like extremely bad health. Like he's a lot younger looking than Minamoto, but Minamoto seems like a spring chicken compared to this guy. He seems like he's on his last legs.
Okay.
Kill him. You'll get a ton of XP, dude. You can have
fun. It's fairly dark in the room, but he has like a. Not a respirator, but you know, like
medical. A breather.
Yes. Stuff like that.
Okay.
And it seems to be like, most of it seems to be like it's not just normal equipment. It's like magic. It's like you get a lot of magical like sense from the equipment. It's not just he's a bit old. He's like this guy's a bit. Is a bit fucked up.
Got it. Okay.
And after that, the Minamoto will be like, Right, right. Well, I suppose we do have a summarization of what happened. Tomasa won't let us know. Tomasa will... He'll nod and he'll be like... right, right. So, the reason you're here is that... although we have had reports of... aggressive actions towards you in the past. Nothing so much overt as this. Sugihara sensei is always to smooth things over, but when it comes to the wider populace, well, the society that the school kind of cloisters together and the society outside of it is very much different. But to summarize, I believe that. Shit, what was the casualty rate?
Was that quiet, Jess?
Oh, mutilation warehouse. Let's see.
Mutilation warehouse. Oh, that's what it was called before he showed up? Well, I mean, what did they expect?
Well, he only took pieces off of three people.
Yeah. That's still, they're not wrong. It's
no.
Just a smaller mutilation.
I believe that in terms of direct casualties, there were three people with amputated limbs, there were four with extreme memory losses, and the rest were shadow scarred, around 20 or 30 people. Some were lost, unfortunately, but it's not really something I don't think that Takinaka would have foreseen. It seems more of a side effect rather than a direct cause. These particular individuals were in bad health to begin with. I suppose the shadow scarring did accelerate that somewhat, but it's hard to tell. Haru just kind of shake his head. So I suppose the main question I should ask is these amputations were very direct, surgical like. What were you needing these materials for?
Well, essentially I was making crystals. From what I understand it, the only thing you could do that is from those who chose to take the deal.
And Tomas will be like, yes, in terms of organic crystallizations, the only way you can do it is somebody who's chosen an alignment for themselves, so. Their matter solidifies and into our naked eye it appears as a crystal. But still, if you had the need for a crystal, then it would have taken significantly longer, but you could have gone through artificial means. Though
there's,
quite expensive.
You there's do, artificial do means?
And Hunter, I will be like... my own dealings within the mythopoetic world, I didn't disclose to my brother. He wouldn't have known of the resources that he had available to him. And Tomas will just look towards Ryu again. Is this true?
I really didn't have much contact with either of my brothers growing up.
Well, I suppose ignorance can be a part of it. It seems though you yourself didn't know of the technique for harvesting them, if you didn't know of the artificial means of gathering these crystals.
No, my persona Vitala was the one that harvested.
Right, I see. So would you say that you lost your influence over Vitala?
No, I chose to do it, and he just gave me the means to do it.
Right. And was there any pressing urgency or need to do this?
Probably no more than expected.
You'll just kind of hear like a disgusted sigh from next to Tomasu. Right, I see. You do realize that when trying to gather sympathy for your cause, well, it's quite lacking. If there are any redeeming features to this, well, I would like to know. It sounds like you did it out of convenience rather than thinking about the consequences of your actions.
Partially, but I was also led, again, when it comes to the contracts, I was led to believe that it was only those who chose to take the dark contract. And in that particular case, those who have taken the dark or light contract are often fighting against each other to gain more power.
And I guess Nakamatsu will cut in, who will be like, when it comes to the cloistered families, we all have our ways of dealing with mythopoetic means. The priests in particular are known for their navigation of these deals, dark, light, mudo, hammer. It's their speciality. Yet from what I've heard, you had a particularly close friendship with the young heir, Nakatomi Katsumi. Surely you did not think to ask her of her opinion of this, or did she not have knowledge to do so?
I didn't ask and didn't exactly make it well known that I was going to do anything like this.
But did you know of her status beforehand, or did you go into this completely blind?
That she has knowledge of this. I did the incident completely blind. I didn't know she knew anything about it until after the incident was done.
I see. Well, it seems that even though you said that you had influence, you didn't have yourself influenced from Batala. It seems that you're saying that you seem to have a deficiency in the in empathy.
I won't completely disagree with that.
And I guess I guess Kuroki will pipe up. He'll be like, I see, so you did this out of mythological curiosity rather than any emotional drive towards it, or was there something, well, a bit more pertaining to a more more humanistic desire, maybe something to do with one of the sins, greed, gluttony, envy, any of those spring to mind?
Well, yes, I was curious about whether what exactly the crystals could and couldn't do, and also whether or not I could actually continue down the path that Fatala wanted me to follow.
And simply just a curiosity, wanting to know what's further down the rabbit hole.
Well, I made the deal with the darkness. I was curious whether or not I was going to be able to go as far down the path as would need be to make it the deal worth it.
And I guess Tomas will be like, but surely you went down this path for a reason. It wasn't just due to curiosity. You said yourself that this was made in. You weren't fully aware of the situation, so you were guided. It sounds like a completely emotional approach as to why you took this deal to begin with.
I took the deal because I guess it feels it was the only way I could be who I thought I was. That seemed every other path that I had done led me to being nothing but failure. Maybe down this path I could finally find what... Maybe I could finally actually stand above others instead of constantly being under them.
I guess Hitomo will speak and you'll be like, so what you're saying is that due to a misguided feeling, you decide to go down this foolish path and cause havoc around you. You do realize that what you said is very much a cause of teenage angst.
Yes. I won't deny that probably what a lot I did had to do with basically me throwing a massive temper tantrum for several years. But again, if I was going to actually figure that in this particular case, easiest path to gain strength in all of this was to take the darkness and go with it. I just found that I don't have the ability to give up my humanity enough to actually be able to go far down that path.
Do you always treat yourself as so detached to these things? You're in quite a predicament, but yet you talk about yourself in the third person, almost, as if you're not quite all there.
Maybe. Just maybe I haven't figured out who I am. I've spent so long wearing a mask, forgot what it is to be what is underneath the mask.
Give me a moment. So, I'll give you roles what you've noticed about each person so far. So, you're not really able to read anything from them. Rip. Alright, so.
Ryu's explaining, he's not exactly expecting a whole lot of sympathy out of this.
Right. Right, and Kuroku would be like, wearing some sort of mask. So, do you find yourself more akin to shadows then, rather than personas? We are in the age of myth, but, the era is dawning pretty soon. Maybe that's a side effect. I have seen reports of people who feel particularly drawn to them lately. There was a bit of an outbreak a couple of decades ago, but it's a bit down quite.
To be honest, I can't really answer to you on that because up until recently I didn't even know much about the shadows. And my real experience with them, which personally, I was told that they were just bygone things that were going to disappear soon, was when I actually opened the rift. But I didn't see anything, didn't see much difference between them and those around me.
So you haven't had any encounters with shadows before your deed?
Not that I'm aware of, no.
So this mask symbology is simply a figure of speech rather than anything in reality, then?
Yes, basically, I use the term mask to symbolize the fact that I was spending so much time trying to, suppose, be what is expected of a Takinaka that I never figured out who I was supposed to be as Ryu.
And Minamoto will speak so in essence, the important thing is what your feelings are now. I could understand that maybe it might be nerves that you're speaking in such a formal matter, but truly, you said earlier that you did regret your actions, and do you feel any sorrow, guilt, apathy?
I do feel guilt over what I've done, and to be quite honest, I don't expect much leniency from coming here. But if it's quite honest, if I was given the chance again, knowing what I know now, I would not go down. I would not do the same thing that I did.
He'll just kind of tap his cane. He'll be like, "I see." You do realize that when you have chosen which path that you will walk down, you cannot change directions. It is as if when you're walking forward, the world in front of you is what you have now, and that behind you is not rendered anymore. It is simply gone.
Yes.
since you do not observe it anymore, then it simply ceases to exist within your general path.
Correct. And whatever happens, I have had no qualms about accepting in that.
I see. And I guess Gendry will say, so to summarize, and what you're telling us is that, well, when it comes to your actions, they were more spurred by, a more primal and less calculated way, rather than a master plan of sorts.
More or less.
And what you're saying, that with guidance and with a new path, that you're, and with a bit more, well, hand-holding would be a bit pedantic, but the same similar notion that you won't do something as tragic as you have done.
Ryu will stop for a minute. It's like, I suppose maybe that would be for the best. I've seemed to make a real mess of it on my own.
And Hitomi will be like, so is the only thing that was stopping you from continuing was us catching you? Would you have continued if your little thing went to plan? It seems that, well, it has been a couple of weeks since the incident, and the only reason why it's come to this point is because of the efforts of another student councilman.
I wouldn't have continued along the path. I don't have what it takes to be what is needed to.
Tommaso will interject, will be like, Shimoda was acting on her own. She was quite reckless, but her heart was in the right place. But still, the responsibility falls on me for not double checking these things. But anyway. Hitomi will be like, really, is that true, or are you just saying that now? Somebody who wished to find, who wished to be better and stronger than their brothers, to suddenly give up at the first hurdle, or isn't that just self-prophesizing your doom?
Maybe, but I also noticed that in my constant discussions with Fatala, he constantly told me that I had to give up my humanity to do all of that, and no matter how hard I tried, I couldn't do that.
So a failure on both ends, then. I suppose you are but a child, after all, trying to be an adult. Tommaso will kind of shake his head. And I guess Minamoto will be like, well, I suppose we've simply established what we've already known. But still, even though Atsuko can be harsh, she does have a point. You are still but a young adult, with not really quite a child, but you're not an adult. The teenage years are the most formative, the raw energy from childhood. It takes a while to realize, and, well, we never do listen to other people's advice when we think that, well, we know what's best for ourselves. So tell me, what do you think is best for yourself, Takina?
At this stage, to be quite honest, I don't know. Every time I've tried to go down and find what is best for myself, I've seemed to have failed.
And Gendo will be like, she'll say, humility is one thing for you, but you do remember that the reason, one of the contributing reasons as to why you're here is that you didn't know what was right or what was wrong for yourself. You seemed to follow whatever path seemed, the most attractive, whether knowingly or unknowingly. You need to think about, well, what do you want to actually do? What do you want to achieve? That's what the Academy provides. It provides you with the raw material and resources to craft something, but you must use the tools for yourself. However much we guide your hand, you must be the one who strikes the iron while it's hot, or it'll just go cold and limp. Hello?
No, you're still there. Considering the fact that Ryu never... Considering the fact that Ryu never had a plan, he just kind of... Actually, I don't know what he would do in this situation. It's like... I suppose in this particular sense, then the only path I have to go down is the same one I intended when I first joined the school. Basically, once all is said and done, just to go and see if I can't continue being an instructor at the dojo I worked at.
In the Haru will speak of, he says, there is some kind of hope in this doom and gloom, even though my brother seems to be quite lost. Personally, he's always had a particular drive and diligence when it comes to his own physical maintenance and well-being. He has helped a family friend at a dojo for quite some years, and even though that discipline has gotten quite well lost at times, with this whole situation and him not knowing what was going on, then surely some leniency can be there. Not all of us were born into great families where this persona business is simply just another step on the rung of life. There is still hope. There is still something there that proves that he did have something going for him that wasn't just, well, being lost to temptation. And you'll just hear a couple of numbers. And he'll be like, so why don't you tell them about what the dojo means to you?
Dojo has been one of the few places where I've actually felt some kind of belonging to. Honda Sensei and his daughter have been pushing me to in the training of it, and actually has been probably the only thing that's actually kept me going in terms of what's been going on for the past couple of years. Without it, high chances are I probably wouldn't even made it to the school.
And that would be like, it is a personal failing of myself and my parents that we did not keep this in check. But I suppose, well, we aren't humans if we don't see any. If we see everything, then we can't exactly call ourselves human. And Minamoto will be like, the boy does speak truth. So when it comes to his learning, when it comes to his athletic achievement, well, he is quite special, though rough around the edges and not knowing the traditional stances. So there is something there that with a good hand and a stern direction, it could be, well, maybe I might have to try if he gets to a certain standard. He'll just kind of smile. And the Kezra will just, he'll just kind of wake up after his stupor and he'll be like, oh, right. Well, I suppose we've come to the conclusion that Miss Takinaki here, he's not gone far beyond redemption. And Genda will nod and she'll be like, Right. I suppose we should lay out a plan for the next steps. Nakamatsu, Kuroki. And Kuroki will be like, right. I believe for the information we've also gathered before you came here is that Haru here, he confirmed that you are wishing to, well, change your mythological standing.
Out of character, a different persona is like, yes, I'm at the moment having a discussion with Fatal about whether he wishes to stay with me or not.
And Hitomi would be like, really? You're having just like an open discussion over tea and biscuits as to whether he can stay or not?
Actually, it's more I'm giving him a chance to leave before he is forced into leaving.
Oh, I suppose that generosity would have been quite appreciated by those who you were left in your wake. But I suppose bygones will be bygones.
I did give them a chance to leave during each encounter.
How thoughtful. Maybe you could have taken that advice for yourself. And Kirk, you'll be like, anyway, enough from the moral compass. So, did you have anything in mind? Or are you completely going into this blind? My God, my nose.
I think in this particular case, Ryu is pretty much blind about what he's going into.
I'm blind. I can't see.
I see. Well, I suppose I'll probably get into more of the, not the mechanics, but the mathy scientist bits.
Specifics.
Right.
The Atlantics.
Thank you, I was about to say that.
Thank you. I can't believe I screwed that up. Kappa.
So, I believe when it comes to analyzing your biological data in the school banks, it seems that your patron is unknown.
At the moment, I have some guesses, but I have nothing to confirm them one way or the other.
Guesses? Well, it will be useful information to update your file anyway. Even if they are just theological.
Out of character, does that mean he wants me to say so, or is that at a later date?
He's trying to get you to say Shin.
I wouldn't want you to have the wrong information in it, so at this particular case, and I think giving the name might cause more issues than could be settled at the moment.
Issues? What possible issues could it cause? Most patrons, they are even awakened, or they are demons, or, well, you get a special case like a Minamoto over there.
And what if I told you it was one of the students at the school?
Ah, a patron at the school? You haven't been underneath until recently. And that area is quite contained. Maybe there's a leak somewhere.
I don't know, but as things are going right now, like I said, I have no real proof other than a lying persona's word on it.
But if it's a student, well, we can certainly look into their files. Just to confirm things.
Right. I suppose in this particular sense, keeping quiet would make it even worse. Then what my persona has told me is it's the student in my class named Shin.
He'll just kind of pause for a bit. And you'll be like, I see. And he'll write it down. Any other guesses?
That's the only one. It's the only name that has been connected to that.
Right, I see. Well, I suppose since your patron is so wishy-washy to begin with, having a new one, it seems like it can slot right in. But I suppose you're not aware, since it seems that you came into contact with your persona out of a miraculous chance rather than anything preordained.
I would have agreed with that. Like I said, other than what my persona has told me, which, again, to be taken with a grain of salt at this stage.
Well, categorically, you are. But anyway, what was I going to say? I don't know what I was going to say. Um... Oh, yeah.
You're gonna say, all right.
Shut up! So...
They're going to take a moment to consider.
So when it comes to poachers, they each have their own speciality. I suppose you could find some other sponsor, but that would take quite some time. And well, it's my own personal recommendation that you keep things in. And the minimator will go well there. I am able to do that for you, but every patron comes with their price of a trial of some sort. It won't come easy to you. It is something that I put everybody through with when they come for guidance in these matters. If you're able to prove that you are a person yourself rather than a follower, then one of the yokai or the kami of these worlds will surely find a match with you.
Well, I will take that under consideration, Sensei.
And it will be like, when it comes to your persona choice, considering the choice you made last time, things under your consideration. I don't think it will go quite that way this time. And I will just kind of put a hand on your shoulder as to be like piped down.
Well, he was going to ask Haru for guidance anyway, so. So like, Ryu will keep his mouth shut. Yeah.
As for other patrons, well. I don't know of any that would be better than myself. And Croak, you'll be like, no, not really. If things are going in a downward spiral, there might be something within here, but I'd have to follow up on the little that I have. When it comes to the students of that class, it's very scattered. And Genji will be like, right, well, the important thing is that I won't be able to personally escort Takinaga, but he will be needed in what he called the cleanup process. The question is whether he goes in with Vitala or not. If he goes in with Vitala, there's a high susceptibility that the persona can run rogue and loose. It's between a rock and a hard place. So there is that possibility. Or if he goes in without it, well. And Nakumetsu will be like, I might be able to procure something of him, especially if they're interested in joining our family. But, well, I need a little bit more assurance rather than I'll take it into my consideration.
Is this the point for Ryu to talk?
Yes.
Let's see, so Haru wants to join FAC, then since Haru's doing it, his answer will basically be, he'll look to Haru and say, I'll follow your lead, whichever you want.
Well, I certainly don't want any more blots on the record. I suppose we'll have to have another talk outside of academy business, since this will be more personal. It'll be like, whether you choose to hedge your bets and go in with your original persona, or have something that's, well, like a band-aid before you're waiting for the mythological surgery. Well, it's not quite mythological surgery, but it might as well be. I can provide some. Especially since you have talent. And I guess Tomas will be asked, like, I suppose this is where we truly do need your judgment, whether you'll be able to handle what sounds like a particularly emotionally stressful period while your persona is in.
You cut out.
TLDR, do you think you can handle it with Atala in the rift?
Okay. Let's see. Would this be an intuition or understanding?
I mean, you're basically trying to understand yourself.
More okay. Of a judgment call.
Yeah.
Yeah. I don't think we're ready for this one.
Yeah. Okay. I'm going to go with... I'm going to use knowledge for Ryu. Just for a personal thing.
Right.
Three. Well, that's not going to work very much well. Let's see. And Vitala's not around, so... Last time...